Here we go. Yep. Do you like spicy food prep, Gabelin? I like hummus with a ton of cayenne pepper in it. It's basically like eating liquid cayenne pepper on chips. It's pretty good. Cayenne pepper. Good. Hey, hello. So there's these giant specimens in here. We don't really know. It sounds like the Earth government came all the way out here to try to use markers as an energy source or something. At no point did they get the idea that this might not have been very smart. Guessing I'm not allowed to interact with these guys yet.
Incredible. We have discovered two nearly pristine specimens, and crews are working around the clock to uncover them. We're learning so much about how these necromorphs communicated. The whole species seems to have been connected by some telepathic signal, from the lowliest foot soldier to the mightiest specimens. But where is the signal coming from? That is what I intend to find out.
White bread? New suit available at suit kiosk. No particular idea why. Suits are cool, I'm not complaining. Take it. Saying there's a. Oh, wow. Where's the nearest suit kiosk? It's right there. I can't possibly miss it. Archaeologist, Eva. Oh, right, because I technically got this far last time and unlocked the archaeologist suit. Then I saved, and it took me backwards. Yeah, that's the one I have on right now. Whatever. This game doesn't have traditional save points like Dead Space 1 and 2. It just kind of auto-saves. So it can be a little bit wonky when you turn it off and turn it back on. Playing all this epic music, he's putting on exactly the same suit we just had equipped before. I think I have all the upgrades that I care about for now, right? And these are all max. I don't care about stasis, I don't care about stasis. Oops. Put that back on. Objective. Drop there. Spicy food's the best. You're missing out, Crab Gable. So good. I think eating spicy food probably involves developing a tolerance so you can even, like, taste anything. I guess that makes me a hypocrite complaining about alcohol all the time but eating lots of spicy food. I'm sure that's the same thing. Oh, you just want to suffer. Well, yes, actually. Why is it the libertarian suit? Yeah, I mentioned that a few times. He'll be in some of the cutscenes where you meet up with other people, and the whole level design seems built around there being multiple people. This is how far I got last time. I didn't go with Hepson to come from behind. Yahan, whenever I go shopping, I buy foods of that require various levels of preparation. And inevitably, I eat them in order of how difficult they are to prepare, or Yeah, in order to be able to repair. So, like, things that I can just take out of the cabinet and eat immediately, I eat first. Things that go in the microwave, I eat second. Things that require the oven, god, third. Alright, so I gotta find a battery somewhere, it looks like. It is where it's drawing me to right now, right? I don't think I can do anything in here until I manage to find a battery and navigate it into this room. So we'll go look for one now. This actually happened last Dead Space 3 session. We pushed back a little bit. This is the way the autosave works. I think Tasty wins out over Spicy. If you can combine those two, that's great. Wouldn't that be nice? What kind of house spouse doesn't know how to cook? Shameful. Okay, so I've been in there. Oh, maybe it's this thing down here. Maybe I can grab that. Yeah. Wait, no, that's the elevator. Ha. Ha ha ha. Those guys are fun. They're nice guys. They seem like they're dicks, but on the whole, they're friendly. I really don't like the new version of the scorpion dudes. Kind of a waste of a med pack, but hey, what are you gonna do? Same thing we eat every night, Pinky. Did you ever watch like reruns of Pinky and the Brain Propagable? I think the universal ammo was a good decision. It wasn't very interesting in the first two games to have to carry different types of it. It made you a lot less likely to try different weapons. This is the guy who's still using the plasma cutter, but I really like the plasma cutter. It's iconic. Quality of life features often reduce the game's complexity. Sort of like Mass Effect 2 versus Mass Effect 1, you know? It's always a trade-off.
Okay, the furnace is on. How's it looking from...
I just dismissed a achievement there, an excellent. Go out the door now. Hey, Sardis. Somewhere out in the world, Sornus's ear twitches even if you're not out on the stream. Hey, Serpent, that's cool. What the hell is attacking? Oh, get the spit shit? I didn't know that was a thing they could do.
Are you all right?
Great.
Hey, thanks for putting up with Robert. You know, he's not been himself.
Norton just thinks I'm trouble in a couple of ways. But you need me for the mission, and that's why I'm here. That plus, well, frankly, I hope...
Allie, is that Isaac? Great, great. You two having a nice little chat?
Look, he just called to say he got the furnace going. He's on his way back now. Isaac, I'll see you soon.
This is still a sweet game. It still improves mechanically on the Dead Space formula in a lot of ways that I enjoy, but man, the romance subplot's really dumb. Love triangle subplot, I should say. Very special. They could have even gone for like a we've got bigger fish to fry kind of thing. That could have been respectful.
Isaac, the heat exchangers are powered up now, but the specimen isn't thawing. Is there something wrong with the mechanism?
Yeah, I think it's frozen shut. I may be able to work it free by adjusting the pressure in the pipes.
Do we really want to thaw this guy? Is that the best idea? Adjust the heaters. Adjusting, okay. Well, I tried that. How does one adjust the balance? Oh. Okay. Is it one of those puzzles? Those puzzles. It'll be fine. Oh, there's a little indicator that tells you exactly what to do. Okay, now I understand. It's not actually a puzzle. Alright, you gotta be quick about it, apparently. You can't just tap it. Likely thing, given the context of Animaniacs, is that it was probably just a gag. But I know that people like fan theories. They play that joke, subvert your expectations quite a bit. That's what most fan theories are, I think. They're fun to talk about, but no. Talking about them in any official context is kind of goofy, I think. Yeah, hey, wouldn't it be neat if this is what they were trying to get at? This is what's actually going on. Holy crap. Oh my god, you're turning on the heat soreness? Oh no! My apartment complex can't have heat and air conditioning at the same time, and they just recently turned off the air conditioning. Which, as I think I've said before, is like my one major vice. I'm a baby about needing to have AC. Yeah, like Darth Jar Jar is pretty goofy. It's fun to talk about, but it's not really a thing.
I think that did it!
Yes! The internal temperature is rising, and I have more good news.
What is it?
Come up to the observation booth. I'll explain it on the way. The necromorphs are conduits for the marker's signals. Well, the researchers built a sensor to track that signal upstream to find the machine.
So where's the sensor?
Probably destroyed, but I did find the blueprints to make a new one.
Great, that sounds like wonderful.
I think I know where this is going.
I like how everyone is on board with this. No one's like, is this really a good idea? Should we really be using a giant necromorph baby monster to, like... Yeah, good plan, guys. You thought of maybe just going home? We'll see where they take... It sounds like they're trying to explore, like, why the necromorphs are the way they are. And I think it's a lot scarier when you just don't know. But you guys have heard me go on about... Exposition is the death of horror, blah blah blah. It'll be fine. Maybe they're getting at that this whole party is like indoctrinated or something. Oh man, I'd kill for some snow, Kami. I love when it's cold.
Over here. This is the blueprint I was telling you about.
Probe
gun? I
don't
see any of the parts necessary to make this sensor, but there's another research warehouse at the other end of the camp. Here's a schematic. What do you think?
Looks like they modified a telemetry spike. I have no idea how it works, but yeah. I think I can build it with the right parts. Where's the other warehouse?
I'll put the coordinates in your rig. It is most likely to be locked down tight. Here. I found these research passcodes when we arrived. They got us into this warehouse. Maybe they will work for the other buildings as well.
Yeah, I can do 55 to 60,
Sarnison. Well, we'll find out. Back soon.
I hope I can piece together enough of this research.
Why are you still here? Oh my god. I was walking away from you. God, some people are so neurotic. You guys are gonna ultimately shoot the probe gun at these things? Hey, the NX! I used to call it jean jacket weather. Not that anyone wears jean jackets anymore. Great sadness. Alright, so the prob's gonna open that up later after I go get this thing they want me to grab. They do like that Britney Spears, J. Tim, all denim outfit. That's the real feature.
Okay, geniuses, here's a question. Let's say the stupid experiment works and you find the machine, then what? Do you guys even have a clue about turning it off?
Turn it off.
Well, Admiral Gray has referred to a codex. She said it was the key to controlling the machine.
You guys really want to turn off the thing that
able to decrypt several of Dr. Serrano's logs, and he references
creepy hallucinations are telling you to turn off?
Instrumental in forging this key.
Are you listening to yourselves? You don't know any more about this bullshit than I do.
If I can find the parts to make a sensor, we can find the machine.
That's a jean jacket.
Then we can figure out this codex business.
Unbelievable.
Oh, you don't like denim? Interesting. I think denim's comfortable. You're perpetually wearing jeans. My office stopped allowing people to wear jeans there, even though we weren't customer-facing, so I wore khaki-colored jeans. Oh, that's cute. Whoa, there's all the candles and shit? That was pretty great. That's a good job, Dead Space 3. There's been too little of that so far, I think. Yeah, this is where we fought the giant, This is where we fought the giant drill boss. They don't really explain it. There's just a bunch of candles here for some reason, and a bunch of soldiers suddenly all have their health drained when you hear a weird sound. Why isn't it happening to Isaac? Oh man, should buy some gaming polos from Fangamer. Got a bunch of polos from them. Good stuff. They might have a Monster Hunter one, I'm not sure. Really cool. I like the look of this area. I think that frozen guy is the boss from Dead Space 1. It's been long enough that I don't remember. Oh, did they slit their throats, Leon? Oh, that makes a lot more sense. Okay. I couldn't tell from that far away, but that makes sense. What? Who's howling? Wine, wine, wine. Actually, I am gonna buy, I will do like a Teespring. There's some website that Ganymede Native was telling me about that's like a Kickstarter for t-shirts, so it's like they won't actually print the t-shirts unless you get enough orders. And I don't think I have enough people right now that would buy them. Well, those guys are gnarly looking. Gross inside out raptor necromorphs, right on. But we'll get there for sure. Alternatively, I could spend like $500 and just buy a ton of shirts in different sizes to be ready for shipping. Running backwards. This is pretty awesome. Is that just a sound thing? That'd be great if that was just sound. Okay. Oh, are these the guys that hide behind the crates? My favorite enemies from Dead Space 2. I could look into it. It's hard to do print on demand. It can be pretty expensive, especially if you're trying to do multiple colors. I have to come up with a design too. Peekaboo! They look way cooler in this one too. Yeah, I feel like that happens a lot less in this one, Jahan. That was a pretty standard MO for Dead Space 1 and 2, that you'd be walking down a narrow hallway and then Necromorphs would spawn in front of and behind you. But I think you get away with this, like, backtracking thing that I've been doing in this one. We'll see if it happens again. But I guess to that end, if you know of like a fairly inexpensive t-shirt printing service that can do them on demand with maybe a few different colors. It should be a Discord DM. I'll look into it. I should probably get one for when I go to cons and that sort of thing. Daily Refectum, Jacob Danik. Many of the faithful have come to me, their beliefs shaken by the horrors they've seen at the liberated marker test sites. How could we continue to believe in the markers when they bring so much pain and suffering, they ask. Who is it that made these aberrations, these copies, I ask them? It is man. Markers are as much a part of nature as were trees and blue sky and pristine oceans. We destroyed those too. Nature is a way of writing itself if we're respectful. It's only by undoing the work of man that the marker's true plan can blossom. Right now, only one man stands in our way, Isaac Clarke. This place is indeed the birthplace of the markers. It's vitally important we stop him from ruining our very salvation. Okay, right on. I'll have to take a look into it. Service.
It means despite our every precaution, containment has become a necessity. It is now up to us to make the ultimate sacrifice for the safety of the sovereign colonies that we have sworn to protect. We understand we cannot expect 100% compliance. Therefore, the military arm of this final quarantine campaign will divide into three tiers of soldiers on sweep and cleanse duty. The first crew disables all vehicles. The next takes census of the personnel who have obeyed the order and provides assistance to those who have not.
Assist non-compliance.
The last all data, records, and communication structures on Tau Volantis and in orbit. At the end of these tasks, each group will consider their mission objectives complete and proceed to self-terminate. God bless the sovereign colonies, and may he have mercy on us all.
I think that someone went to the trouble of, like...
It means despite our every precaution, containment has become a necessity. It is now up to us to make the ultimate sacrifice for the safety of the sovereign colonies that we have sworn to protect. We understand we cannot expect 100% compliance.
The armory, the requisitional pistol, and one bullet for each soldier, shaking like a leaf. Supply chief filled the order and asked if his one was received.
The first crew disables all vehicles.
We shared a final smoke. He told me about his family back home and his vacation plans when he returned. He unzipped a body bag and asked if I wouldn't mind spotting for him. He apologized for being a heavy fellow and said if I could, his body should be taken below like the rest. I hesitated at first, but he calmly sat down in the sack like it was a sleeping bag, said a quick prayer, and then he offed himself. Once his remains had been tended to, I gathered my order and noticed the jitters had gone. I guess I'm not afraid to die anymore. That's pretty cool. I like this.
It means despite our every precaution, containment has become a necessity. It is now up to us to make the ultimate sacrifice for the safety of the sovereign colonies that we have sworn to protect. We understand we cannot expect 100% compliance. Therefore, the military
General Spencer
Mahad.
It's an all-hands scenario. Fives been declared. All flights are grounded. Do not attempt to contact the fleet. Report to your superior officer for orders. No percent compliance is required. This is not a drill. God save the colonies.
Assistance to those who have not. The last destroys all data, records, and communication structures on Tau Volantis and in orbit. At the end of these tasks...
That's progress, so let's go the other way first. Is this one of those tungsten things? I think I have a
sovereign colonies.
Yeah.
Have mercy on us all. If you are watching this film, it means despite our every precaution, containment has become a necessity. It is now up to us to make sacrifice for the safety.
Double torque bar, what does it mean? All the way. Repeater. Cool. Upgrade circuits. Plus 2 rate of fire, minus 1 damage. Nope. I think I want damage. I think I want to be able to take off limbs. It feels like a lot of the necromorphs in this game are balanced around having a fully upgraded weapon, at least compared to the earlier titles on the same precaution.
Containment has become a necessity. It is now up to us to make the ultimate sacrifice for the safety of the we have sworn to protect. We understand we cannot.
Hey, it's the peekaboo necromorphs. Sounds are a little excessive, don't you guys think? These guys are so fun. They peek their head out, it's cute. Buddy. Like, so this room, it was fairly easy for me to just stand back by this thing here in relative safety. Maybe it's crazier if you're in here co-op, though. The other person runs out. The inventory limit again here soon if this keeps up. You don't need to yell when you punch a box. I guess he doesn't know that what he's doing is punching a box, right? Okay, I understand this mechanic better now. I didn't really understand how the search bots worked before. Makes more sense. And you hear that sound, so you know when it's worth even bothering to check, I guess. Before, I thought it was like, you know, just shoot the robot in this direction. It must be above me somewhere. That's progress. Let's see what else is going on. You do need to yell when box punching. I guess that goes to show me, like, I've never punched a box before. At least not with purpose. With intent. I really shouldn't be criticizing Isaac Clarke when I'm not myself a big box puncher. Oh, interesting. I wonder if when you do this co-op, if both people have to press the confirm button at the same time, you know? That would be interesting. Oh, those aren't... they're not symmetric. Super forgiving puzzles intended for two players. Punch, kick, it's all in the mind. kick a punch, it's all in the mind. If you want to test me, I'm sure you'll find.
But... Okay, Scott.
Hey, thanks for the follow, Helena. How are you doing?
Whoa. Hey guys. Whatever they were experimenting on here, it looks like it got up and took half the warehouse with it.
Oh no! What about the sensor parts?
Three pieces, right? Well, it's a long shot, but I'll take a look around.
Oh, the timer even changes on difficulties? I figured the difficulty would just be combat six gun. That's cool. Did you play this game on co-op, or did you do it solo? What'd I miss? If you guys use that exclamation point secret or chess command, it's the same alias. If you would also let me know what thing I missed. Just because of the chat delay, it'll take me about 20 seconds, even though I hear the ding right when you type it. Rate of fire, minus one reload. Don't think those are all unique. Oh, good looking out, thank you. Grab it here in a second. What's the worst LARP mechanic you've ever seen, Sornis? Okay. Okay, you're just a spooky thing cracking open there. Nothing actually happening, that's cool. I don't think they actually have nodes in this one. So anything we find is good. A lot of loot. Worrying amount of loot. I wonder if we're about to have a boss fight. Alright, that's a bummer. Are you thinking about building a PC, Helena? Satisfying endeavor.
Okay,
recommended.
Santos. I think I've got all the parts for the sensor.
Excellent. Do you think you can reconstruct it?
I just need to find a bench and call up the blueprint. It shouldn't be too difficult.
Uh-huh. Something's gonna happen. All benches in the game are now broken. Oh, that's a really cool concept. Yeah, right, Sornis? Maybe think about that differently. Right on. Look into... I think my favorite website that I've had other people use is called logicalincrements.com. If you've never built a PC before. It's updated fairly regularly, and it gives you a bunch of... different parts that you can mix and match to build your new PC. So it's really useful if you're not sure what to buy. Hey, what do you know? It's a boss fight! That explains why they gave us all that ammo before. What a shock. So this game is more action-oriented. I would almost not even call it a horror game. In the way that like Doom isn't really a horror game. But I think they want to be, as much as that's necessary to give you a bunch of ammo before a boss fight, I think they need to be careful to not, shit, ouch. Telegraph that much, you know? Just be trapped in the corner here? Is that a thing that can happen? You gonna let me out, dude? Some people's necromorphs, man. dodge rolling like it's Dark Souls. Ouch. Oh, come on, man. No! Well, that works. There's one. Hey, time to split. Thanks for the hosts. What have you been streaming lately? There we go. That's the one. Hey, Praf, what's grooving? Oh, Mario 64, awesome. Which version are you playing? Are you doing 64DS? Hey, thanks for the follow. Folks popping in, hey, I'm trying to beat every awesome game. Check out the games I've played so far at games.marsled.com. And vote for the next game at vote.marsled.com. For those of you in chat, if you haven't followed Time to Split yet, you should do so. twitch.tv/timetosplit1. No! PC part picker is good as well. Would you recommend PC part picker over logical increments, Leon? I've only ever really messed around with logical, so I'm not sure. Ouch. I think this is one fight that's made quite a bit harder by insisting on using the plasma cutter. It's really not the best weapon for shooting this guy. Especially with the side tentacles, the way they pop out like that. Bye bye. Spider fellow.
Guys, that beast thing keeps running away before I can kill it.
Sure.
Can't catch a break. But if the sensor works, we will have the machine's location.
If this planet doesn't kill us first.
We'll find it. I'll be back soon.
So looking for a bench. I guess we'll stick to objective for now.
Hey, anyone been out to check the armory?
No. Why?
Oh, shit. That's what I thought. Someone with a trail of flares and they're still burning.
Oh, God. You don't think Danik and his men are
gonna find absolutely out. Think Danik and his men. Right, make sure that you get the motherboard with the right slot, for example.
It is now up to us to make the ultimate sacrifice for the safety of the sovereign colonies that we
Oh, is this a different room?
We understand we cannot expect 100% compliance.
No, I think this is the same room I was just in. Just maybe I didn't finish looting everything in here. Maybe it's changing on the second way back. That's funny. I don't think that's ever happened before, opening loot and having a little bug in there. Yikes, Leon. Yeah, if you like Google how to build a computer, holy shit. To say the least. Necromorphs that use guns, that's fun. Oh, baby head in there, that's great. Ouch. Maybe we can try to not get hit with grenades in the future. Would be good. Oh, what's the ROM hack time to split? I haven't followed that community very much at all. What does it change about the game? I did Mario 64 as part of my 24-hour Mario stream, so we just did Mario 64 DS, and I beat it as fast as I could. I think I did 8 hours, which was fast for me. So I didn't do a lot of the optional stars and things like that. Get a robot here. Yeah. Check what's over here first. Cover all our bases. Really, on Nintendo Life? Interesting. Oh, you know, I bet this is looping back to the big open area from way before? Well, maybe not. Maybe this is just a dead end. I think I've been here before, though. This seems familiar. This particular area, I think it's meant to be a place to send one of those scavenger robots out. Oh, wow. So it's like, it's almost like a mod. It's all using the same physics as the original Mario 64, though. It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's cool to see more and more,
Okay, Isaac, I am done fucking around here.
Fully featured Denica mods, hacks.
We can take one, get out of here. If you care at all about Ellie, you will do this for her.
Haven't you been paying attention? We're the only hope of saving our entire race.
There is no hope.
That's
Isaac,
awesome.
None.
Is there any concern then that it's
going to
get a cease and desist from
planet.
Nintendo time split? Better camera, that's good. Major setback in expanding Facility 1 today. Glacier collapse took 23 men, 2 tractors, and 3 unfinished buildings. Initial surveys have shown that telemetry spikes, as protocol suggests, but failed to report the unstable ice mass. Loss of supplies and manpower will be a serious setback to the expedition staying on the schedule. Bummer, guys. It's a bummer. Airflow. Nope. Oh, they bring in power-ups from other Mario games? They have, like, the Tanuki suit and things like that? I wonder if at that point they try to, like, keep... Because Mario 64 is a fairly glitchy game, right? It makes it good for speedrunning. You can do a lot of physics shenanigans, skip stuff. I wonder if they kind of built in intentional skips. Quote, intentional. Like we see in some Metroidvania titles. Right, yeah, same thing with another Metroid 2 remake. I was bummed out about that. I was really looking forward to that remake because Metroid 2 is like the most. Has aged more poorly than any other Metroid game, so it's probably the most deserving of a remake. I think that's just taking me back. So we're gonna go this way instead. Fancy loading screen rooms. I wish Nintendo would be a little bit cooler about that. Nintendo is one of my favorite developers, but they make some questionable decisions when it comes to just the internet in general, I think. They're always about a generation behind. Hey. Oh, yikes, Jahan. How embarrassing. Probe gun. I like how they make it impossible for you to screw that up. Other scavenger bots probably gonna be back soon. I should make another tungsten bar here. Some dark bar, actually. Let me make 2 of them. So I don't have to worry about it. I love not worrying, having to worry about shit. I'll bring 1 of these. Inventory space, but...
Wow. This looks pretty lethal for science equipment.
No, I didn't get to play the Metroid 2 remake. I followed it for years, and I think it got the C&D within like days of it going live, right? I played the demo that was out for a while. That was it. Hey, guys. Oh, probe gun's actually pretty good for killing shit, it looks like. So they added flood, that's fun. But with like Mario 64 style physics. Hey, Namaku, how you doing? More crap in here, I think. I could have killed everybody. So it shoots these little telemetry spikes, but they also murder necromorphs pretty well. Good number of shots on it, too, it looks like. I need them. Hey, friend! You're cutie. Cutie cutie. Oh, you're so spooky. He's so spooky. He just kind of gave up and fell down there. I feel like, maybe this isn't true, but I was under the impression that in Dead Space 1 and 2, you would fire shots to bring the enemy down, and then they could always still get up if you didn't finish them off and see the item drop off of them. But in this one, I think that stomping them when they're on the ground or shooting them when they're on the ground just makes sure you get loot for them. I don't think they can ever get back up and start attacking you again. I'm doing all right. Having fun with Dead Space 3. Playing this for about another 3 hours, and then it's sub-block today. Which is Brigandine, that cool strategy RPG. Some more Bayonetta and some more Legend of Dragoon. All good games. Puke on me, man. It's not necessarily that when they're on the ground they're dead, but there's a dead phase and then there's a loot them phase. They definitely stop moving after a bit. We need to kill these babies. Stop them from possessing new corpses constantly. It's a lot of unnecessary extra damage for me to take. I love that they connect onto their heads though. That's such a cool looking animation. Oh, that's awesome. That's so much better than... much better than the babies in the previous games, which aren't all that scary. Alright. Everything's fine, everything's good. Some days you wake up and you're on fire. Alright. Well... they're not telling me to go to the bench, are they? Okay, because they're already crapped. Check my inventory after we did a couple of short shootouts there. Ho-ho! Not a fan of Dead Space 3, Namaku? I think it's alright. It's definitely, you know, you can feel the tendrils of EA around it. It's even more action-focused than a series that was already trending more action than horror. And the story is a bit silly. Got some issues with like the love triangle stuff they've implemented. But I think that the game is really solid. Like, it's really polished, it's well made. Presentation is good, the environment design is good, the enemy design is good. Oh, okay. very infrequently. Although, technically for Subblock, you don't have to stick to awesome games. You can have me play whatever you like. I move it from week to week based on people's schedule preferences, time to split. I used to do it on Mondays, but since, you know, some people only tune in when I first start streaming, like a lot of the European viewers,
who's that?
Don't
folks
worry
that can't stay up quite as late.
Dick.
And a lot of people have a better time late at night in, like, U.S. prime time. I move it around from week to week. Really, his interaction with Ellie's boyfriend is just so stupid. It's unnecessary for them to behave that way. It's borderline unbelievable given the situation that they're in, you know? Hold on. I'm confused. Okay, shoot the thing in the brain. That's what I thought they were going with us getting this probe. exactly do they all want me to shoot this thing? No. Can't talk to these guys. Maybe I can shoot into these machines? Is that what they're getting at here? Oh. Solid, acceptable game. Interesting. I know, right? This is the marker homeworld. Can we gain a little bit of perspective, guys? Come on. Yeah, sure, Leon. That'd be awesome. Thank you. So it's really just those two things, and then we should be able to shoot into there, question mark? Maybe, possibly?
Isaac, you'll need to ride the cage out to the opening.
Fantastic. No, let's go ride into the giant necromorph monster.
You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, uh-huh. Whatever. Get in the cage.
Thanks, Norton. There is no earthly reason for this guy to be such an ass. Hey, we're entering the body cavity. Fantastic.
So Santos, how will this work exactly?
Use the gun sensor attachment to locate a nerve cluster. It should ping when you're close.
And then what?
Shoot a probe into it, I suppose. My telemetry should light up and we'll have the location of the machine. Finally, something simple, right?
Right.
Yeah, I'm sure that's how that's gonna work out. Locate synapses. Okay. Aim probe gum and listen for beeps to find the active synapses.
God, Santos, it's moving!
Yeah, are you
Don't
shocked?
Worry, it's quite dead.
Uh-huh, yeah, it's quite dead. I'm sure it is.
You sure about that?
Who is surprised by this? Is anyone in the whole world surprised by this? Well, that's cool. I like the skeleton eyeballs. It's kind of like it's a cool twist, but the way they went at it, you're like, what are you guys doing? It's that bad horror trope where, like, the horror protagonists are going down into the basement. Like, why? Haven't you seen a horror movie before? Why do you think this is gonna work?
Isaac, are you alright?
This thing's got one hell of a defense mechanism. Well, did it work?
No. The signal is just a trickle. I can't get a fix on any specific location.
All right. We're gonna find another nerve cluster.
Yes, good idea. That should boost the signal.
Those ones don't count as being active? Okay. Whatevs. Isaac Clarke on tech support and said it. Giant necromorph mom.
So come and get me.
Is everything
the whole thing moving?
Yeah. Look, I want to get out of here. How's the signal?
Definitely stronger, but...
One more?
One more.
One more. Where's the necromorphs? Where are they? Are they not spawned this time? Is it opposite day? I guess those are the things making sounds. Oh, you're supposed to hit them in the torso six gun? That explains why they were taking so long to kill. Is the head work too, or just the torso we want to go for? Whoa! Pretty sure that's using some of the same assets of the Reaper Collector Vision from Mass Effect 1 and 2.
It worked! I've got to fix on the machine's location.
Santos! Not now!
That's not very good, really. Yeah, right. Those were screams. Shooting at their eyeballs? Oh, okay. That's unusual. They're actually going for traditional, like, zombie headshots in these guys, I guess.
Okay. That better be the last time. Santos,
so
please tell me you got what you needed.
Yes, thank you. It will take me a moment to sift through the data.
Fine.
Making bad decisions. Making bad decisions, girl.
Ready when you are, Norton.
Questionable decisions on the part of the protagonist, yeah.
Santos, we have a fix on the machine?
Yes. There are thousands of signals, all concentrated far below the planet's surface. That has to be it. There's an entrance further up the mountain beneath a second dig site.
Further up the mountains? They're sheer cliffs.
Well, I saw some climbing gear stored below. Santos and I will start setting up at the base of the cliff. Norton, can you make sure Isaac gets out safely?
Sure. Sure, I'll take care of him. And Ellie.
Yeah.
I love you. You know that, right?
Okay, so he's about to die.
Yeah, of course. Isaac, meet us at the cliff.
Got it.
No one's been more about to die than that guy right now. Sorry, so I had a year of Twitch Turbo, and I'm trying to get a refund because, you know, Twitch Prime
Norton,
does the same
open the
thing.
Cage.
Is he going to not open the cage? God damn it.
What?
Of course.
You want to die here, now's your chance. I'm taking control of this mission again.
Hey!
This guy's such a douchebag.
Where are you going?
Anyway, they asked me to send them my receipt from PayPal for buying Norton. Twitch Turbo.
Nice!
Okay, whatever.
Norton!
Ellie, can you hear me? Damn it, he jammed my signal.
Yeah, I'll find it later. There's just no way for me to get out, or can I just do it from over here? Okay. Sucks to be you, dude. I have kinesis, like everyone else in the Dead Space universe, and can open gates myself. Yeah, right? Okay, going in the elevator here. July 1st. Okay. See if I can find it. Update my inventory. Yeah, he's gonna turn on us and then die. Opening us up to reinvigorate our relationship with the female lead. As stupid as that is. Alright, 8? There we go. Going next. Interior crocodile alligator. I drive a Chevrolet movie theater. Nothing here. Fight more of those peekaboo necromorphs? I hope so. Oh, man, pay attention, dude. Oh no, what a shock.
You wouldn't believe the trouble you've saved me.
Nice work.
What?
Dude, oh, Elton John over here.
The marker killer, Isaac Clarke. And here we
are. The marker killer, huh?
The marker homeworld.
Pretty cool name.
You know, I must admit, I almost didn't believe such a place existed. But thanks to your friend, Norton, I finally found it. That's how they followed us through shock space.
Well, oh, he is a bright one. All he wants is Isaac. Carver, the rest of us can go home.
Deluded son of a...
You've got me. Let the others go.
It's a very difficult thing, you know, undoing the damage man has done. Everything we touch, we contaminate, we corrupt. The markers had a plan for us, but we took what should have been a magnificent gift and perverted it.
Jesus, spare us the bullshit.
I've spent an entire lifetime trying to undo the damage man has done. Fighting EarthGov's ongoing research, liberating the markers from those profane testing facilities. And now, I just have one problem
left. Good point, Puller.
All of you.
No, you promised me a ship, Danik. We had a deal.
Oh, surprise! He betrayed us. Oh, my goodness.
I can't afford to leave even one.
Holy shoot.
Alive.
Holy darn.
Apologies for misleading you, Captain.
No, not Elton John!
Did that get him?
No, of course not. We're gonna have to fight Elton John Necromorph is gonna be the final boss of this game. Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal. Hey, it's our buddy! Oh wait, no, that's another more different buddy.
Fucking kidding me.
The dude in blue is the co-op character if we were playing co-op. This looks like the boss from the first game. Ow. Let me see, Hey, that's what I'm talking about right there. Oh, hi. Oh, hi, Mark. There we go. Living that dream. that's gonna be a death animation. Maybe it'll spit us out and we'll get to keep playing. Oh, that was nice of him. Thanks, man. I wonder if you can stop that from happening. I'm not sure. Rolling, rolling, rolling. Thanks for showing me your heart there, Brosif. I appreciate that. You think so? Thanks, buddy. That was kind of excessive conveyance there. Like, the fact that the entire Dead Space series has been teaching us that yellow equals shoot it. We probably didn't need him to yell that out there. Maybe in one of the earliest fights where we learned that, that could be nice. Oh my god. Subtle telegraphing, right? They should at least wait to do that until you've been stuck for a while, right? Oh wow, I was lucky. Right, Serpent? Whoops, I walked directly into the giant claw. Dark Souls rolling? Perhaps I should try some roving. That's a lot of eggs. Aw, no extra damage there. No, but all of the little eggs drop ammo when you kill them, so you effectively have infinite ammo. Constant source of extra enemies to give you ammo. I don't know what to shoot anymore there. Maybe I am supposed to shoot the red stuff? Oh, maybe it's that once it's all red, he eats you. It's like the Zone Seeker from Final Fantasy VI. That's pretty cool. That's rad. I like that twist. Mechanically, that was a cool fight. The only thing I didn't like about it was your buddy constantly telling you to shoot the yellow bits. Uh-huh. Ew. Oh, cool. That's actually kind of a well-done animation. I wonder if they, like, designed that with colonoscopy videos or something. Hey, more yellow shit. The best. Oh, that's cool. It's using the same air and, like, space travel. I'm just inside the digestive system of an ultra necromorph. It's pretty rad. Come on, let me see your junk. All that junk inside that trunk. Come on, there we go. I think this was the thing I defrosted, yeah. There's an origin achievement called Intestinal Fortitude. That's why their art department watched 20 hours of colonoscopy videos. The thing that was totally 100% dead, Brabagable? Yeah, I think that was the thing. Ow.
You made us come down here. You
are you seriously gonna kick me after the shit I just did? Oh my god, this guy really needs to take some context.
I tried to save us. You are the real problem here, Clark, but not anymore.
Captain!
Stand down, Sergeant! This is all your fucking fault. She doesn't love you.
Dude, he really needs to, like, consider the situation a little bit better.
Fuck. Oh, fuck. Come on. He won't stay dead forever, not around here.
Well, I mean, he will if we, like, amputate everything.
Tell him the truth. Now let's go.
So that's the player two guy. So petty and stupid. She's my ex-girlfriend. Making sure he doesn't come back. You know, I'm not like working out any aggression on douchebag McGee. I would also work out that aggression on Isaac for also being a douche about it, you know? Yeah, I know, right? He's gonna come back. Guys, think about this for a second. We have options. This isn't a totally unavoidable situation. Yeah, right? Well, Isaac is a creep. In a way that they explored and that was fun in Dead Space 2, I think. Maybe they're just figuring it's a given in this game. They don't really need to go into it anymore. Yeah, we know Isaac's kind of a crazy creep. Ooh, plus 2 damage, plus 1 reload. That's the first time we've gotten a plus 2 that's all upside. Probably crap a bunch of those too. Damage. Let me see if I can craft some too. Yeah, I totally can. See the other ones that are plus 2 damage. Damage is my life in this game. I think I need to put those. I don't remember if we confirmed 100% that only the ones on top matter. But we'll do that first, and then move the other ones down. The rest of these we want to be clip and damage, I think. Yeah, if we can. Oh, where's the rest of my... I could have sworn I had way more clip circuits. Oh, I know what I'm doing wrong. There we go. Hey, me shooting his corpse and stomping him was a completely, absolutely, 100% rational act in this universe. Isaac Clarke is the hero of his own story. But seriously, like, you can't be like, oh, he's gonna come back soon, and not, like, stomp the shit out of him to stop that from happening. What is a honey one badger? Oh, a honey badger? Is that what it's supposed to be? Is it something I can actually look at? Hold on. It's supposed to be some kind of honey badger joke, but I didn't get an actual indicator for it. Why can't I see what the honey badger is? Yeah, just proper safety protocols. That's what you do. You stomp the shit out of your ex-dead friends. Hey girl, hey, good news! He stomped the shit. He has no body parts anymore. He's mostly just a torso.
Is he?
He's a torso.
I shot him, Ellie.
Well, don't present it that way, dude! Oh my god.
What? I'm sorry.
No, don't.
I have no choice.
Dude, this is the romantic comedy problem where it's like, just phrase it, present it in the correct order.
Isaac did what he had to do to save the mission.
Guess you guys don't care.
Come on, we gotta keep moving.
Now they're
Then we leave you behind.
That's the thing that's stopping you from doing this? Resurrecting the ancient necromorph demon. Okay, alright.
Nobody's leaving anybody.
No, not the asshole. Oh man, that's too much now. Now I've got PTSD.
Together. Together.
I can't take him seriously in that golden outfit. I assume that was in the default game, right? How interesting. What the hell is this thing? Oh, cool. Oh yeah, we learned how to do this at the very beginning of the game.
We're gonna start an avalanche if we all try to climb this.
What do we do?
I'll climb up first and have a look around.
They really needed to do like an icebreaker, polar brewski, a team building exercise. I think that would have been appropriate. Play some Parcheesi. Chinese checkers or something. Are there any really good board games to make sure that you're not an indoctrinated necromorph slave? Because that would probably help them out a little bit. Just a hair. Ages 4 and up. I bet Don't Break the Ice is pretty good for that one. And then when you got the little hammers, you gotta tap little ice cubes. Kinda like Kerplunk. Yeah, two truths and a lie. Would have solved all of these people's problems. Ow. Minimal consequences for getting hit by giant boulders, yeah. Maybe I took some damage from that. That appears to be the case. I did, in fact, take a small amount of damage. I am on the lowest difficulty, though. You don't want them to play a solved game like Connect Four. That just, I think that creates strife among peer groups.
Ellie, come on. Norton was pointing a gun at my face. I'm sorry.
Is that supposed to make
sense? Of course,
okay?
To sucker barfs.
You never believed in me, or this mission, or us.
Endless Hitler jokes about necromorphs.
And now he's dead. He sabotaged it. Just like everything else.
What's that supposed to mean? Is that what you really think?
Yes. They brought you here at gunpoint. I guess that's what it took.
Ugh. I'm not here because someone put a gun to my head.
Yeah, well, Norton's dead because someone put one to his.
I mean, the whole situation is stupid, but that was a pretty good comeback, you gotta admit. That's one of those oh snap type situations. Yeah, secret Hitler. Someone do ad quote for that? There's no way Secret Hitler could create strife. That's good. Hey, more frames. Oh man, could think about all those guns I might be using if I wasn't going. Is this necromorph mining? Yeah, I get it. You're having a pissy day. So. Any necromorph with red eyes, I want to shoot them in the face instead of in the limbs, or is it just the ones that look like humanoids? Hey, what's up, bro? Oh, there's actually a game called Secret Hitler? No, I've never heard of it before. What kind of game is it? Oh. Okie dokie. Yeah. Howdy. Oh, awesome. That sounds great. I think bluffing games can be fun. I did, not Mafia, not Werewolf, not Bang. There's one that's like, it's supposed to be with spies, like the Resistance and something else. Played that a couple times and had fun with it. Keeping your poker face when everyone at the table is like, you know. I mean, Dylan's trustworthy, so we can totally believe what he just said. Okay. Charred skin zombies are headshot only? Okay. I just figured they were particularly resilient. Thanks for the heads up. I don't think that's something I would have figured out on my own. It would be nice, almost, if you had to headshot them to kill them. Didn't feel like that was correct.
Guys, I found a cargo.
I don't think it was called Coup.
It's wedged into the cliff.
I'll know the name when I see it, I think.
Set it down. Ellie, you hear me?
We see it. Come on, Ellie.
It might be the Resistance. That sounds right, Ludifex. Do I have to, like, oh, that makes sense. Giant blue thing. Oh, that's cool.
Ellie, can you see it? Ellie!
Oh god! Look out! That's us! Get behind me!
Ah, shit! Try to drive it away!
Ellie! Ellie! Ellie!
A problem with those sort of Mafia-style games is they usually don't have a ton of depth to them, and they're really hard to play with the same group, I think. You start to figure out each other's optimal strategies. Having a little bit more depth, maybe a few more mechanics is cool. Different victory conditions. You're still alive. Good job, I'm proud of you. You survived a lot. That Necromorph was a survivor. Oh, that's interesting, loot effects. Oh, interesting. Okay, makes sense. I think I get a reduced benefit for having things in the bottom section, because I have an extra clip. That kind of doesn't make sense. It still works, so I'm not complaining. Oh, ammo support. I think I found that earlier. Oh, that's fun. Hey, evil dogs! Sucks to be you, evil dog. Y'all are not immune to falling rocks. They called this game Dead Hoth. Most of it takes place in this ice planet. Like, they still got this little zero-G oxygen sequence earlier.
Isaac, we're okay.
We were swimming around in the Necromorph's butt.
Oh, thank God.
Look, about Robert. I just don't understand why he would try to kill you.
He blamed
really?
You for
have
the
you
trouble
paid attention? He kept Ellie, pushing oh my to God. Go home.
I kept pushing to stay.
All those times he said, I want to kill you.
But I thought Robert understood that.
I'm here for you. I mean that.
You're going to be the rebound guy now, Isaac. Man. Isaac is not a really classy person. Dead Space 1, when he wasn't talking, you could, like, project whatever you wanted to him. He could have been a dapper fellow, full of class. At least give it a week, man. Hello. I think that guy's explosive arm thing fell into the ground. Hello. Howdy. Stop dropping your body parts through the earth. Yeah, it's really weird. Like, I don't know what led Visceral to include it, because the first game got by with having almost no dialogue at all. And none of the dialogue was about interpersonal drama. It just, it doesn't fit in this universe, I don't think. It can be done well in different settings, but maybe they're trying to do the zombie trope where, like, you know, when zombies are around, eventually it's other humans are a much bigger threat. But it just, it doesn't feel convincing in this setting so far. Oh, cool, yeah, I've heard awesome things about Beyond Good and Evil. I've never actually played it before. I do not own it yet. To locate hidden resource caches. Oh, I guess it's a third tiny robot. Cool. I like myself some tiny robots.
Okay, I found another lift point. Still no winch. You guys all right?
Yeah, good looking out. Appreciate it.
We just hit the cage.
Grab it after stream.
It's pretty bad up here. I hope I find a winch soon.
Isaac, just be careful. I don't need to lose both you and Robert in the same day.
Thanks, winch Ellie. Searching is hard and dangerous. Trouble you go through for a block and tackle. That's cool. Haven't had to use that in a while. I guess that's why they gave us like 3 stasis packs on the way up here, huh? Not going so great, but hey, we're not dead. Ouch. Man, they're really brutal about where they want me to jump over here, I guess. Hey, we didn't die. Fantastic. So I only really know about Beyond Good and Evil from title recognition. Like, what's the game like? What kind of game is it? Ow. What? Yeah, that extra damage is paying off here. Person action adventure. Oh, that's cool. Really like Terminator Prince of Persia type game.
We're gonna start it up. Hang on to something.
Wait. I don't like this.
Just talk to me. Don't look down. What's our next step?
Well, we now know that in order to turn off the machine, we'll need some sort of key. The researchers called it the Codex.
Okay. So where is it?
We have to make one.
And how do we do that?
The same way they did 200 years ago with Rosetta's research. Oh my God!
Take it easy, take it easy. Just blown a fuse. Maybe I can divert power from the lights.
Oh, that's cool.
So, tell me about this, Rosetta.
Well, we don't
balance
know much.
The power.
Just that the Codex was made from her research.
Where will we find it?
In the facility at the top of this mountain.
90-70-50.
We're almost done.
210. And what is it? 260? So we gotta get 50 over? But over on the right, okay. That was easy enough. There's probably a less stupid way to do that. Really? I never thought Civilization games would have challenging hardware requirements. I wonder if that's actually because the game is that demanding, or it's
see,
just like
so bad. Not bad.
People are getting lazier as they expect people to have more powerful hardware. So it's not quite as optimized. Oh, Spider Bro!
No,
face down and us with it.
I can reach her. Just hang on to the winch. Santos! Give me your head!
Isaac, it's too late for that!
Take it! Cover now! No!
Later, Santos. Well...
God damn it! I had her!
It was gonna take us all down with it!
Isaac, the cliff's falling apart!
Come on, Jim!
Not sure how I feel about that.
I could have breached her if I just had another second!
Great. Hey. Oh, CPU limited. Interesting. I didn't think about that. Okay. That's crazy. The AI is that good in general?
Isaac!
She's gone. Ellie.
Isaac, it was pulling the whole cliff down. You couldn't have saved her. Can you get back up here?
Yeah. I think there's a way up around the side.
I don't know, I kind of wonder whether Isaac would be the one to be like, no, we can't save them. You know, he's kind of had a bad time. Hey, this guy again. What's up, buddy? Long time no see. Fight the boss normally? Alright, hold on.
Try to lure him to those tracking lasers!
Can do. I hope this is actually a two-player event. Oh, nice.
Use the torque control, quick! He's gonna break free!
Where's the torque control at? Is that this thing? Crank available. Crank available. What the hell? Oh. Shit. Okay, well, I think I understand what I'm supposed to do now. Come here, Broseph. Ripping off his body armor or something? That's pretty cool. You gotta admit. That was pretty well done. I like it, how long they stretched that out, too. Yay! First try. No problem. You're not actually a corpse. He dropped a scat parts box. He dropped that raid loot. Hooray, what a nice guy. Right. Let's go to the mall today. I might need to do some overclocking myself. I've never done that before, but I'm confident I can figure it out. I've got one of those, like, easy mode CPUs that's built with overclocking in mind. So. Oh, that season pass stuff? Yeah, that's frustrating. Yeah, announcing like season pass DLC. They're already planning on it.
I'm so sorry.
This must be the place. But how the hell do we find this Rosetta?
Slightly better than day one DLC. Like, I guess I'm probably going to buy the DLC for a game eventually anyway, so they give you my discount for getting it, whatever.
We can take that to the entrance.
It just feels slimy. Hey, Death Ghost. Yeah, we didn't have to try that hard to convince her that it was the right decision. We tried to save the science lady who like had the bright idea of shooting telemetry spikes into a giant dead mechamorph, and we couldn't save her because everyone would have died otherwise. And Isaac was bummed about it for a few minutes, and it made Ellie be like, oh, he actually is still a sweet, nice fellow, not just a boyfriend murderer. Aww. Yeah, right, Propagable?
Oh, shit.
Are you alright?
This is not a time for kissing.
Yeah,
maybe the writers on this one, that's how they think relationships work.
You go on ahead.
I see a ground route. I'll shoot directions to your rig. We'll meet at the facility.
Cool. I actually kind of appreciate these contrived reasons for you to not actually be with the other characters so that you don't have to worry about... Sorry, you don't have to worry about escort missions, which I think everyone agrees are the worst. Loved in Bioshock Infinite, it's like, you don't have to worry about Elizabeth. She can take care of herself. Sweet. I think the only games I've played that make escort missions work are games that are completely built around escort missions. And not, like, Daikatana. I still need to play almost all of Eco. I've only seen, like, a level or two. But Eco, I understand, is a game that's designed as one big escort mission. Still super good. Yeah, I was showing, for those of you who played Final Fantasy XIV before, I was showing Polar Brewski more of the game, and he got to some of those leave quests that are an escort mission, and instead of like the guy you're escorting just walking to his destination, you have to type /beckon, the beckon emote, over and over and over to get him to walk all the way. And it's like, hey guys, we've got an emote system and you can use it in this story. Whoa, what's that gnarly looking moon thing? Why haven't I noticed that before? Have I just not been looking in the right part of the sky? Has it just been occluded, like they did earlier with Saturn when we were on Titan Station? Yeah, I think it's good that you're always alone just from a gameplay perspective. Horror works better that way too. Especially this setting where that's kind of been Isaac's deal. He's almost always by himself. Daikatana was John Romero's game. It's a pretty famous failing. Like, the ad campaign was kind of aggressive and rude to players. John Romero's gonna make you his bitch. And then it was really unpolished, and it was a big sequence of escort missions where your AI companions were really, really likely to get themselves killed. That's no moon. That's a PlayStation.
Looks like Danica's had time to regroup.
What did Daikatana do? Suck badly.
How do we find Rosetta if she's been dead for 200 years?
Wait a minute. There. Rosetta Lab. It's here.
Perfect.
Hey, chest high walls.
Send me the coordinates.
I wonder if I'm about to fight some...
find us before we can build this codex.
I wonder if Danica's gonna find us before we can build this codex. Alright, maybe not right now, but on our way out of here, it's gonna happen. Because video game. Right. The names of things in this game aren't terribly subtle. Oh, you're on board the lost ship, the Roanoke. Oh, wow. They wanted to get lost. That's fun. Yeah, yeah, I hear you behind me. It is, well, you necromorphs. I think the charred ones are just harder. Like, I've taken their heads off before, they just keep coming at you. They just have more hit points. New suit available at suit kiosk. Hey, that's pretty neat. Where is the nearest suit kiosk? This way. Well, he's having the same problem we were having. I mean, speak for himself too, but... remember we were playing it, how frustrating it was to go for like 8 hours with no interesting content. It's like all fetch quests and bullshit. It's like a lot of these NPCs in like starting areas are kind of generic. I'm like, yeah, that's 1.0. Pretty bad. Let's see. Man, I use a ton of ammo on those guys. I'm gonna need to start carrying a little bit more. Silent Hill 3 is pretty scary. Silent Hill 2, I think, is the scariest for me, just because it's a lot of psychological horror. I think any married person will be extra distressed by Silent Hill. Don't you dare give Polar Brewski shit for playing as a potato, Kami. Be nice. He always gives Hapax and Matzo shit for playing as potatoes, even though they're clearly the best race. Best potatoes. Hey, we're not looking like a shiny golden person anymore. Oh, is this like a combat uniform? Okay, it's military armor. I kind of like the engineer suit, but alright, whatever. It's the action game, that's okay. Don't have the key yet. This is how I came in, isn't it? Just going right back outside. Oh, there's some loot there that I missed. Maybe like a text log or something? Seeker rifle. Oh, maybe that the thing I picked up, the honey badger, was a weapon blueprint. I think that's what it was. We'll go see if we can find the bench again here. Was this the outfit the Jenkins character was wearing at the beginning of the game? Looks familiar. Alright, first and foremost, we have way more inventory slots, well, 5 more inventory slots, but given how much ammo we're using now, that's a good thing. Take it. Blueprints, what's the honey badger? An advanced rivet shotgun and a hydraulic eviscerator modified for flame damage and ammo conservation. What makes that a honey badger weapon? Is it don't give a shit? Come on. Come on. There you go. Polar Brewski was showing me Truck Simulator earlier. I hadn't seen the game. I just heard that people think it's really awesome. It looks really cool. I was like, so is there a way you can beat this game? He's like, I don't think so. Maybe if we find like an achievement. That'll be the new free play day. Stop everything on stream. All American Truck Simulator for the next 6 months.
Oh, finally. And this is an assembly station. According to the controls.
So we're here to assemble a codex. That makes sense.
It seems like a fun room.
Yeah,
no problem.
According to this, we're here to assemble Rosetta. They cut her into pieces? Oh my god.
Fuck, I mean...
They sliced her up.
Sorry, that's the best line in the history of the Dead Space series. They cut her up? Fuck this day.
Why?
It was just so deadpan.
But some of the piece is already in the assembly. I think I see another piece over there.
Yeah. Have you played Silent Hill 2 before, Death Ghost? I think I recommend it. It's a little bit better than 3. 3 ties into like the main Silent Hill lore a bit more. It's more of a direct sequel to 1, whereas 2 is more of like an anthology spiritual successor.
What the hell do we do?
Well, there should be a receptacle that feeds that into the lab's cataloging system. Yep, over there.
Hey, okay. Body part cataloging. We're building a necromorph key, I guess? I don't know. We gotta turn off this machine because they keep singing this song from the Book of Mormon musical in everybody's heads. Turn it off. And every time we hear it, we're like, yeah, that's a totally good idea. That's a thought that I had myself. Not like the words of a crazy person written in multiple text logs in all caps.
So, according to the records, there are 4 more pieces. They were checked
out
of storage by Dr. Serrano.
Check out body parts.
Well, there are 3 buildings in the facility. So if there are more pieces,
gotta go get the fire crystal and the ice crystal. We gotta go to the jungle temple to get
down from what I could see.
The earth necromorph.
Yeah, well, you're in luck.
PET scan body part.
Look what I found, a security pass. You wanna give it a shot?
Hey, why not? Great, thanks. Find out what you can about how assembling Rosetta will create a codex. I'll explore the labs and recover the rest of these.
Get it? Because Rosetta's slab, not like... It's not your mama's Rosetta slab. It's the slab of a necromorph body.
It looks like there are three primary buildings in this facility.
That's super frustrating, Leon. I'm sorry to hear
that. There's one for paleontology and one for geological studies.
I'm glad you've heard that song, though, because every time they say turn it off, it's going to turn it off.
Just
like a light switch, just go click, click, click. It's a cool little Mormon trick. Do it all the time.
I know. Isaac out.
Feeling certain feelings that just don't seem right. Treat those pesky feelings like a reading light. Alright, got my favorite enemies. I really hope that they make Book of Mormon into a movie so more people can see it. It's really hard to get tickets to it. My wife and I were lucky in San Francisco and caught the tickets right when they went on sale.
It's blocking some of the doorways.
Is it organic?
Pay better attention in here. Might be a good idea. Stop letting things damage me over and over and over. Gas pump offline. Text log. Let's move in. In the event of containment failure, sterilization gas must be administered from the nearest sterilization booth. These airtight chambers will protect you from the highly corrosive sterilization gas. All unprotected biological tissue in the affected area will be disintegrated. It's important that the sterilization gas mixing station be maintained at all times. Your safety and the safety of those around you depend on it. Grab. Oh, hi. Oh, I see you now. Where are they coming from? Glad that they glow in the dark. That's helpful. Maybe not the best survival decision for them. Kick the baby. I gotta get some more health packs. Oh, yikes. Okay. +160 plus this is 140, 240. Yay! That was easy. Guess we can't take the lift back up after we do that. No, maybe I didn't actually solve it. That would explain why nothing happened. Okay. So we want to get them both in the green. It's not necessarily about balancing them. There we go. Yeah, I think we can all agree that Thanalan and the Shroud are both pretty boring. Lanosha is a little bit less bad, but it's still a lot of open nothing. Not a lot of interesting, like, geographical architectural kind of thing. We got both the pump and the elevators. We can get out of here now. I'm not sure. I'll think about that once we beat the game, Death Ghost. This is my first time playing Dead Space 3, so I'm not sure where the story is going to go. One sec, guys. Oops. So that we don't get slowdown and CPU issues, I have to split my VOD. So if you're watching on YouTube in the future, the next part's going to occur immediately after this one. Be right back.